Get to the chairs yet?
Nope.
All right, I think I got him.
He's middle back row. Yeah, literally middle back row.
All right. You guys see Mia at all?
I ask everyone to please rise for the Star Spangled Banner. Gentlemen, please remove your hats.
Alexandra Gruver, and I am proud to serve as this year's senior class president. On behalf of Hanover's 2021 graduating class, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome parents, relatives, teachers, administrators, school board members, and fellow graduates to this year's commencement ceremony. I would also like to recognize the class of 1971 alumni. It is truly an honor to have you here with us today. Thank you all for joining us tonight as we acknowledge the accomplishments and celebrate the closing of a chapter for the class of 2021.
Do you know where the song's from? Les Miserables.
Thank you.
Good evening to parents, guardians, and guests. It is my pleasure to recognize the top 10 students for the class of 2021. It is important to note that these names are being read in alphabetical order and not in the order of class rank. Students, please stand and remain standing when I'm calling your names. Tiana Colehouse Gray. Madison Martin. Jitsiri Mendez Valdez. Emily Mora Ballion. Nicholas Shaw. Regan Smith. Aaliyah Krug Snedeker. Annika Zito. The salutatorian for the class of 2021 is Aubrey Kaler. And finally, the valedictorian for the class of 2021 is Alexandra Gruver. Thank you. I'd like to thank you all for coming out and supporting the graduating class of 2021. Now that we've finally arrived at this long-awaited moment in time, I find the opportunity to deliver some stray thoughts before the ceremony commences and we part to paint our unestablished history. While I had a number of potential interests to speak of, I decided it would be beneficial to share my feelings on a concept I often find myself at war with, numbers. These figures, birthed from the point of zero, continuously appear to promote pride as well as prolong my torment in every equation, calculation, and counter question. In case you haven't picked up my signal, I would not consider myself to be a math-minded individual. But that holds no relevance, as I am not here to lecture you on the scholastic significance of numbers. Instead, I want to provide a perspective on the philosophy of numbers and how they relate not only to our graduates, but to everyone here tonight connected to the number 2021. Numbers can mean nothing or everything. It is up to you to decide. Oftentimes, we count the negatives of shortened possibility and the apparent limitations of our power, giving these figures more credit than they deserve. In this context, no is not a number, but it might as well be. It tells us of the things we should avoid and the lines we should not cross to reach our prioritized objectives. Ultimately, we crunch to calculate and rank to label, but numbers only gain the power of influence if we surrender our thrones of individuality. Yet the positivity of numbers can also shine through account of every star and every prospect we identify in a distant glimmer, only reachable across the unimaginable visualization of infinite digits. To the class of 2021, numbers may measure the quantity of times we felt the reassuring qualities of happiness, pain, and purpose. They may designate truth from lies and wins from losses, only giving way to the roots of the human condition. This is where we are set to see how the strategies of others may give over time, while the direction of an individual path not yet charted, however similar it may be, holds greater value. And now, as we proceed today as graduates of the 21st year of the 21st century, remember and remind yourself in future moments of strife, that you lead your own charge to the undefined sides of connected seas. Realize that numbers often mean more to a step than they do the product of a cleared path, leaving behind a divide in the movement between every person's sense of self. Understand the whisper-like weight of numbers in the classification of your worth, and keep these final instructions for any challenge that may come your way. For those counting the concrete numbers of our predecessors' paths to success, they may refine us, but to release truly motivated minds, they should not drive us and will never define us. Thank you.
Good evening. On behalf of the class of 2021, I'd like to welcome and thank everyone for supporting us on this special day. I'd especially like to thank our school board, teachers and staff, and Dr. Scola for his leadership this past year in giving us the freedom to choose between in-person and virtual learning. To my fellow graduates, congratulations. I'm thankful to have spent this last 13 years with each and every one of you. Today, we become Hanover High School graduates. We join an esteemed alumni comprised of doctors and lawyers, teachers and therapists, musicians and engineers, architects and nurses. The groundwork laid here at Hanover High School will make anything possible. Our diplomas will contribute to our success in life. Each one of us has had unique experiences at Hanover High School, a combination of both good and bad times, times of laughter and joy, times of school spirit, and of course, times of panic when we forgot to study for a test the next day. Through everything thrown at us this year, the class of 2021 never gave up on each other. Although we had our ups and downs, we have shown the powerful meaning of family through our fortitude and perseverance. While we all may be a little apprehensive about what lies ahead, we can be confident in knowing that we are well prepared for facing any challenge. As our Hanover Public education comes to an end, our class flower, a white rose, symbolizes the beginning for each one of us, a new journey in life. I'd like to wish everyone the best of luck in the next chapter of your life. Thank you, Nighthawks, for all the memories I'll never forget. Here's to the class of 2021. Thank you.
Graduation, I fumbled for the right words that could possibly encompass the past 4 years of our lives. Reflecting on our years at Hanover High School, I became totally overwhelmed as so many memories flashed through my mind. From our first pep rally, where Chris and Dominic swung their shirts to the air with school spirit, to the senior tailgate that became overly popular on social media, our class has shared some of the most cherishable moments together. Our class is a combination of students who have attended Hanover since kindergarten and those who have joined us along the journey. I have gone to Hanover my whole life, starting at Washington Elementary, where I met some of my closest friends. Reaching middle school, we were thrown into classes with new faces, the people with whom we would spend the next 8 years. Our class grew up together, from our first day of fifth grade to this very moment where we are all seated together for our graduation. Entering high school, we were always told from our parents, guardians, and teachers how quickly the next 4 years would go. However, I don't think any of us believed just how quickly it would fly. As all of our teachers and administrators know, our class has always enjoyed creating chaos, but that does not dismiss all the valuable lessons throughout our time at Hanover. Starting with freshman year, we began to recognize the importance of balance as each individual explored their interests, whether it be through clubs, sports, or participating in musicals. We adjusted to the increased freedom of the high school environment easily. We glided through freshman year, reaching a slightly more challenging sophomore year. Classes got harder, requiring more effort, studying, and additional homework than we were used to, especially for those of us who took on the challenges of A+ in chemistry. While we maneuvered through the obstacles of freshman and sophomore year, junior year was a different story. None of us were prepared for what the year would hold. In March, we got the exciting news of a 2-week break. By the second day, the world was put on pause as COVID was proclaimed a pandemic. Little did we know that two-week vacation would turn into an entire lockdown, ending our junior year early. Everything came to a halt as we went from going to school every day to online coursework, between, of course, binge-watching Tiger King and Outer Banks on Netflix. Slowly but surely, fewer and fewer FaceTime calls were administered as lockdown ended and we reunited with friends and family. Although the end of our junior year was stolen from us by the pandemic, we remained hopeful in the idea our senior year would be normal. Unfortunately, that was not the case. We began our year half virtual, alternating days to attend in-person school. While the teachers put in an immense amount of effort to make online classes comprehensible, there is no doubt online learning is quite a change to the in-person experience to which we were accustomed. Our senior year was not what we had intended. Still, we worked through all the barriers the coronavirus entailed, including multiple quarantines for some of us. With some students fully virtual to others partaking in in-person classes, we have all proven our capability to evolve during unforeseen circumstances. We still share plenty of laughs in the comments with our senior privileges when we weren't at Sheets or Dunkin' Donuts. Both the athletic and theatrical departments were successful as we had the opportunity to cheer on those participating in sports and even seeing teams or individuals move on to districts. Those sitting here today have put in the necessary work and effort to graduate, which is quite an accomplishment considering everything we have endured. The students of the class of 2021 should be proud. With the guidance of our administration, we took an abnormal year and made the best of it. We persevered, and perseverance is a commendable trait to possess. Whatever path each of us chose, whether it's acquiring a further education, diving into the workforce, or serving our country, everyone has the perseverance to do whatever they set their minds to. This class portrays the essential characteristics to be successful as we move forward. The pandemic may have ruined a lot of things, but we still got to gather here today to celebrate our graduation. Moving through life, remember to take advantage of opportunities, as you never know when they will be taken away. Something that became very prominent over the last year and a half. On that note, let's enjoy this last moment together before we all part ways on our separate paths. We did it. Congratulations to the class of 2021.
Good evening, Principal Abels, Superintendent Scola, Board of Education members, parents, relatives and friends of the class of 2021, classmates from the class of 1971, and the graduating class of 2021, excuse me. As President of the Hanover Alumni Association, it's my privilege to present two Golden Scholarships to deserving students from the class of 2021. Hopefully, we will be able to get members of your class to become members of the Alumni Association before you turn to your 50th reunion. Your high school guidance office, as well as your high school office, has contact information, and we would love to have you join our association. But now, the important part is to announce two winners of our Golden Scholarships. The first scholarship recipient is going to a person who will be furthering their education with a technical emphasis. This is a $4,000 scholarship, usually dispersed in two 2,000 stipends during their pursuit of a technical post-secondary certificate. This year's winner is Olivia Phillips. Olivia, could you come forward? The second scholarship recipient is going to a person who will be furthering their education in the pursuit of a bachelor's degree or higher in the field of their choice. This is an $8,000 scholarship, usually dispersed in $2,000 stipends during their pursuit of a post-secondary bachelor's or higher degree. The winner is Aaliyah Snedeker. It's also my honor to address the class of 2021 on behalf of the Hanover High School Alumni Association, and also from the class of 1971 who's celebrating their 50th reunion. Believe it or not, 50 years ago, we were sitting where you folks are, and we were ready to receive our diplomas. I promise you my remarks will be brief. Over the years, I've had the privilege to address many graduating high school classes, and the last thing I want to do is make you suffer through some old guy reading a speech. So I will be brief. So let's decide what a Nighthawk means. According to Marvel Comics, the Nighthawk is a villain who turns into be a superhero, which all of you are this evening because you're graduating from high school. The United States Air Force built Nighthawks as stealth fighters for the military purposes. So again, quite an accomplishment. So let's take a moment here and decide our own definition of what a Hanover Nighthawk is. And let's use the letters from the word Nighthawk. We can have some fun with this and put a little twist to it since we are all Hanover Nighthawks. N is for that never give up attitude. This should be your mantra when things get a little tough in your life. As Steve Jobs, the founder of Apple, put it, if you are working on something that you really care about, you don't have to be pushed. The vision will pull you. I is for inspiration. The inspiration to others around you. John Wooden, the famous UCLA basketball coach, is quoted as saying, things work out best for those who make the best of how things work out. G is for gratitude. Without gratitude and humility, the world will see right through you and you will be known as a shallow person. H is for healthy lifestyle. Maintaining a healthy lifestyle not only will benefit yourself, but it will benefit those that you love and care about. T is for thoughtfulness. Those that think of themselves before others are living by the golden rule. H is for humor. If you can't have some humor in your life and even laugh at yourself, you may be destined for heartaches and tears down the road of life. A is for attitude. There are many motivational specialists that have used this thought process, so I want you to listen very carefully. It is your attitude, not your aptitude, that will determine your altitude. W is for wise. The wise person always listens to the facts before jumping to conclusions. And K is for knowledge. Without the thirst for knowledge in life, will become pretty pedestrian. But if you have a thirst for knowledge, the sky is the limit. As Ben Franklin once said, an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. Congratulations, class of 2021, and thank you for allowing the members of the class of 1971 to join you in this very important event. Please know that we wish you all the health and prosperity in your future. Congratulations.
Sitting down with my guidance counselor, Mrs. Henry, the summer before my freshman year as we discussed my plans for moving from Southwestern to Hanover. I told her right then and there that my goal over the next 4 years was to graduate as valedictorian. Now, throughout this time, I've stuck to my word, challenging myself with countless AP classes and pushing myself within those classes to receive stellar grades. Every once in a while, a thought will come to mind, and I type it in my notes under graduation speech ideas. While you might find it to be overzealous, I consider myself more of a planner. I thought I prepared myself to the best of my ability, but when finally asked to write the speech, I was stumped. While the abundance of our class has been together for an astounding 13 years, I've only had the pleasure of being here for 4. I cannot stand here and reminisce about the memories you all have made since elementary school, because unfortunately, I was not a part of them. I can, however, talk about the times we've shared throughout high school. As cliche as it sounds, it truly seems as though just yesterday we were wide-eyed freshmen, still nervous about navigating through the halls to get to class on time. I remember our first time in the football student section and how eager we were to eventually sit in the front as seniors. I remember our first homecoming and arguably the best. Freshman year flew by in the blink of an eye, and next came sophomore year. With a little more authority came more responsibilities. As some of us decided to take on our first advanced placement course with squirrel connoisseur Miss Cosdren, we began to realize that hard work must be put in to receive a successful outcome. We weren't used to having hours of homework and certainly weren't aware that we actually had to study for these tests. However, we came out on top, and I am thankful for the lessons that class had taught us. As junior year rolled around, we all began to grasp the true meaning of high school. We tried new sports, joined new clubs, and truly diverged from our comfort zones. I wholeheartedly believe that we were the class everyone wanted to be. If pep rallies involved wins and losses, our class would be undefeated. From sporting events to dances to typical days in school, the class of 2021 left an everlasting mark. As juniors, it already felt as though we were top dogs. What could have been one of the greatest years of high school quickly came to an unexpected end. In March of 2020, we were thrilled to begin our 2-week break from school. What we didn't know was that our high school experience would never be normal again. 2 weeks turned to 2 months, and just like that, we became seniors. At the time, I felt indifferent. I was so ready to become a senior, but on the other hand, I was scared that my last 180 days of school would pass by as quickly as the others had. And of course, they sure did. It would be wrong to disregard the fact that we were stripped of so many high school stereotypical memories. While we were fortunate enough to receive a prom, COVID restrictions kept it from being glamorous like those in the movie. We didn't get pep rallies, and like we were waiting for, we never got to sit in the front row at football games. The saddest thing of all was that it took a global pandemic for us to realize how fortunate we were and how precious these true years were. Every time I had a rough day at school, I found myself counting down the days until graduation. Never in a million years would I have thought that it would be here so quickly. In Ferris Bueller's Day Off, Ferris states, life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you might miss it. The corny quote from, ironically, a high school slacker actually encompasses our senior year pretty well. We couldn't wait for Christmas break and then summer and finally graduation. Now that it's here, I'm sure I can speak for most of us when I say that I wish I could sit in a classroom once more or roll my eyes while Costco drones on for what feels like hours in the commons. What this year has taught me is that we as students crave the future entirely too often, and in turn, we take the present for granted. With that being said, my message to the class of 2021 is this. I know you all are embarking on new and exciting chapters of your lives. Some of you are off to college to fulfill your academic goals. Some of you are heading into the workforce to begin your careers. Others are chasing your passions or simply taking the time to figure out what it is that you want to do in life. Whatever it is that you're doing, take your time. We've learned firsthand just how rapidly time can pass. I know all of you are going to accomplish remarkable things in your futures, and you should be extremely proud of how far you've come already. Just remember to stop every once in a while and take it all in. All the work you've put in, the memories you've cherished, the good days and the bad ones too. All of these moments will shape you, and I am overwhelmingly grateful for how Hanover High School has shaped us all over the years. Thank you to the parents, teachers, families, and friends who have been part of such a rewarding process. And to the class of 2021, congratulations.
What's that?
Good evening, parents and guests, and welcome to graduation for the class of 2021. First and foremost, I would like to thank the School Board of Directors and Dr. Scola for giving us an opportunity to experience an amazing school year with in-person instruction. I also want to thank all of the parents and guests. Thank you for supporting your children and making sure they did what they needed to do to get to graduation, even during such trying times. It is just just as much a testament to you all as it is to those students who you see on the field. Your guidance, love, and support have molded these students into the people that they are today. To the students of the class of 2021, many of you know that I have a framed canvas with my favorite Rocky Balboa quote in my office. This quote comes from a conversation that Rocky has with his son. In it, he says, "You, me, or nobody is going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much can you take and keep moving forward? Because that's how winning is done." You, the students of the class of 2021, like all of us, have been hit hard over the last 15 months. Not all of you might see this now, but I feel confident that the last 15 months has taught you a lot about how to be successful in life. Life is full of joyous and amazing moments, but occasionally the hits will come. If you can take the hits, stay strong, and continue moving forward, you will be successful. We have persevered through the last 15 months and have been able to have in-person instruction, athletics, the musical, numerous awards banquets, the prom, mini-thon, and now here we are on one of the most important nights of your lives so far, your graduation. This moment marks the beginning of what will be a bright future, and I am so proud of you all for all of the things that you have accomplished. Grit and resilience will carry you further in life than almost any other character trait. Take the hits, stand tall, and now go forward and live your dreams. Parents, thank you all so much for your unwavering support of your children. Students, thank you for all of your hard work over the last 4 years. And once again, congratulations to the class of 2021. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Scola, the superintendent of the Hanover Public School District, to the podium. Thank you.
Good evening. On behalf of the administration and board of school directors, I want to congratulate the class of 2021. As we leave the 2021 school year behind, we want to thank everyone involved for your ongoing support of the Hanover Public School District and our students and staff. This year brought us challenges, but it also brought us together. We are so proud of the positive impact the district has been able to have on students and their families when they needed us the most. This commencement exercise is a testament to our ability to push through the adversity, control the circumstances that surround us, and use every means at our disposal to meet the needs of the students. As I look around, I am sincerely grateful that this commencement ceremony is inclusive of all stakeholders and that we can celebrate this joyous occasion together. This class has accrued an outstanding record that has brought a great deal of prestige to Hanover High School. I am most proud to announce that the graduating seniors from the class of 2021 have earned $1,403,836 in scholarships from technical schools, community colleges, and universities, and $336,434.21 from local organizations and generous individuals. In total, the class of 2021 has amassed $1,740,270.21 in scholarships and awards. Congratulations.
That's impressive. Yeah, that's impressive.
Class, look to your right. Appreciate the unique and grand tradition of the 50th class reunion. 50 years from now, many of you will return to Hanover High School, once again, touch the oak tree, and participate in graduation. Always remember, be proud to be a Nighthawk. And as you embark on your successful life journey, remember, tradition never graduates. You are a Nighthawk now and forever. Now, it is with great honor and pride that I present this class for graduation. Will the class of 2021 please stand? Class of 2021, by the authority vested in my office as the superintendent of schools through the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I now certify that members of the graduating class of Hanover High School have successfully completed the requirements for graduation, are eligible to receive their diplomas. You may now turn your tassel from right to left. Will come forward at this time. Congratulations.
Avery Sienna Abel. Abigail Elizabeth Alden. Gabriel Reed Albert. Adon Orlando Arita Espana. Ava Carolina Arita Espana. Estefania Arriaga Martinez. Jason Shaquib Barudi. Macy Cheyenne Beckworth. Samantha Ray Bleeker. Jessica Marie Bowers. Aubrey Marie Taylor. Catherine Mitchell Capps. Dawson Cole Cassette. Tiana Alexis Colehow Gray. Carly Beth Adele Calgill. Riley Wayne Q. Zane Henry Driscoll. Lindsay Elizabeth Dutter. Abigail Grace Duvall. Ashley Lizette Ike. Alyssa Rose Fiorelli. Zachary Walter Flickinger. Brittany Nicole Fowl. Rolando Alfonso Garcia. Christian Alejandro Garcia Tercio. Kyle Allen Garman.
Joseph Gebhardt. Dakota Allen Godfrey. Devin James Grams. Toby Aloysius Groff. Tyler Michael Groff. Sierra Nicole Hahn. Deontay Anthony Harris. Sienna Bree Henderson. Brandon Fidel Hernandez. Derek Brent Hetrick. Lexis Marie Hippensteel. Erin Sophia Homan.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Jocelyn Faith Imler. Jasmine Elizabeth Johnson. Kayla Marie Kaufman. Pete Allen Kessler.
The faces may change, Beck, but the names never do.
Paul Michael Killinger. Benjamin Clayton Kahn. Dalton Lane Kirby. Trent Allen Knob. Madeline May Kuhn. Keith Moon Light. Jason Nathaniel Lewis Jr. Dylan Tyler Loudermilk. David Ulysses Lupien. Hannah Elizabeth Lynn.
Do you see Mia in there
Colin
yet?
Colin Michael Leiston.
Do you see Mia in there yet? She's got to be coming up.
No, not yet. Christopher Pete Magana.
I see her. Yeah.
Graciela Denise Menjarez Beltran. Madison Marie Martin. Eric Martinez Ramirez. Ty William Meckley. Yam Miguel Melendez Esquelin. Jetsiri Mendez Valdez. Mia Lisa Minetos.
All right.
Christopher Alexander Montoya. Emily Mora Bylon.
Just wants to kill somebody right now.
David
That was hilarious.
You know I'm videoing this
Trenton
whole thing.
Carter.
So I got it. I got it all.
Zaire Trayvon Allen Miles.
What's that?
Oh, I see on his phone.
Right.
Diego Nicolas Miguel.
Without it, I couldn't follow any of this.
Jose Nicolas Miguel. Shay Marie Pilato. Olivia Sue Phillips. Spencer Leroy Poole. John Angel Ramirez. Andrew Michael Reck.
All right. I figure with a name like Stremmel, he was going to be back in the back.
Leilani Michelle Romero Morales.
A lot of letters.
Alicia Rose Marie Rosario. Brian Sanchez.
Say that again.
Tyler, pay attention. His bro is leaving. He wasn't going with him.
Was he just sitting there?
Nicholas Christopher Shaw.
Do you see him?
I think I see him.
Monique Alexandra Showers. Regan Marie Smith. Aaliyah Christina Krupp Snedeker. Aiden Tyler Snively. Dylan Francisco Solis Valorin. Julia Ashlyn Spielman. Ariella Destiny Stansbury. Emily Faith Stevens.
Tyler's next.
Okay. Yeah, there he is.
Tyler Patrick Strummel.
Tyler!
Hadley Noel Sutherland. Dominic Michael Taylor. Olivia Justine Popper. Chelsea Inez Valdez. Perla Estrella Vasquez. Vitaly Olsovandrovich Ferrope. Sorry. Brooke Marie Wagner. Jewel Renee Watson. Tyler Luke Wentz. Ryan Michael White has joined the Marines and is unable to be in attendance tonight.
What?
Pierce Xavier yes. Williams. Lennon Harrison Wilt. Jackson Douglas Wise. Monica Louise Zito. Haley Lynn Zollicoffer. Malcolm Ryan Gerlach. Alexandra Danielle Gruber. Samantha Rebecca Lockman. Maria De Jesus Mendez Lopez.
the class of 2021 stands before you, acknowledging that today is one of the biggest milestones we have reached so far. However, it is clear that we could not be here today without the support of so many people. We have been luckier than most due to the empathy, encouragement, and unconditional support we have received since the very first day of our educational journey at Hanover. To our families, we thank you for always cheering us on, whether it's sporting events, music groups, honor societies, or anything in between. Our dreams would remain dreams without your constant enthusiasm to participate in anything our hearts desired. Now you can finally exhale. We've made it. To our teachers, we thank you for presenting us with limitless knowledge. It is, without a doubt, your devotion to our success that has left us with memories and lessons that will last a lifetime. We cannot thank you enough for being so much more than just educators. To the Hanover Public School District, we thank you for always providing us with any creative outlet we could dream of. It is truly astounding that while exercising our minds, we're also able to pursue nearly any passion we developed along the years. This is the privilege that HPSE has bestowed upon us, and for that, we are eternally grateful. To our classmates, thank you for always being there to lend a helping hand. Our bond has survived group projects, pep rallies, where we may have gone overboard at times, AP classes, and even a pandemic. As we go our separate ways, may we always acknowledge that our time spent together was full of growth and camaraderie. To the members of the Hanover High School class of 1971, we thank you for being with us today. We could not be more elated to receive the honor of joining you and carrying on Nighthawk pride for years to come. There may not be a certain answer for what comes next, but we must vow to never let our doubts or insecurities be a contributing factor to our success rate. As Harry Styles once said, you have a choice to live or to exist. It's all in our hands now, but I know that we're ready. Let's live.
Would everyone please rise for the alma mater?
Oh!